Verse 29, Pachagovinda. Arthamanartham bhavaye nityam nastitata sukhalesha satyam putradapi dhana bhajambhite sarva त्रैषा वीतारीति भज गोविंदम गोविंदम भज मूढ़मते। अर्थम अनर्थम भावय नित्यम नास्ति तत सुखलेश सत्यम। वेल्थ इज कैलामिटेशियस, reflect all the time, truly there is not the least happiness from it. The wealthy fear even the sun. Putradapi dhana bhajam bhiti. This is how it is ordained everywhere. Sarvatraisha bhita riti. Wealth is pronounced calamitous in the same sense as electricity is. Electricity is detrimental, even fatal, if contacted wrongly. But it is of great use when you maintain right contact with it. So is it with wealth. As long as you maintain a proper relationship with wealth, it serves you well. But few know the art of relating properly with it. A wrong relationship can produce bitterness and suffering. Hence, the advice is to reflect carefully over the part that wealth plays in your life. Avoid any negative development. Use it positively for your betterment. Wealth is something which could be exchanged for sense objects. Money can buy color and form for the eyes, sound for the ears, smell for the nose, taste for the tongue, and touch for the skin, but not emotion or knowledge. Wealth cannot get you happiness. Happiness is subtle, wealth is gross. Gross cannot control the subtle, nor acquire the subtle. Yet the entire world runs after wealth to procure peace and happiness. Bear this truth in mind in your transactions in life. On careful analysis, you will find that your transactions with wealth produce more sorrow than joy. Firstly, earning money involves struggle and strain. When you possess wealth, others covet it. Your next problem is to preserve it, keep it away from predators. Lastly, the parting of wealth is even more painful. Hence, the verse proclaims that the wealthy even dreads that his own son may wrench it from him. The money psychology is that it hurts you all along your association with it. The desire for money is painful, and since unfulfilled desires cause mental agitation, when however your desire is fulfilled, develop greed for more, and when you have amassed wealth, you become arrogant at those who have less than you and envious at those who have more. Of course, all along you are possessed with the fear of losing your wealth. These emotions are harbingers of sorrow. Therein lies no happiness. Yet humanity pursues wealth all through life without reflecting on the consequences of one's association with it. So here's a small story. Two schoolmates met after a long time. One was a wealthy businessman and another a spiritual recluse. They were meeting, and over their meeting, they lost their way. And they reached one side of the river infested with wild animals. The rich man's mansion lay on the other side of the river, and they had to cross the river, and there was this ferryman who refused to take them across. The businessman tempted him with a huge sum of money, and then the ferryman yielded, and they reached the safety of the rich man's house. Both the friends exchanged lots of experiences and the life that the ascetic has chosen for himself. What was the use of your life for renunciation? And the wealthy man said, had it not been for my wealth, we would have been devoured by wolves this evening. The ascetic, the friend, rejoined, dear mate, is it the possession of the wealth or its dispensation that saved us? If you had not parted with your wealth, we would perhaps have been a victim of the wolves. Amazed at his analysis, the businessman turned a follower of the ascetic.